Dr. Carl Dieffenbach from the National Institutes of Health shares his observations on the 2015 conference on retroviruses and opportunistic infections.
Hello, everybody. It's great to be joining you from CROI here in Seattle. As always, this conference promises to have many important research findings, both in improvement of the types of activities and therapies that we are using, but also in some novel groundbreaking areas and activities. We look forward to visiting with you many times this week on the AIDS.gov website, but stay tuned. CROI is going to have some real important research to report out. As CROI gets started this week in Seattle, we really have some very significant themes that we can discuss. We have major results coming out in HIV prevention, as well as in the area of hepatitis C. The interesting thing about the prevention work that's going to come out is it deals with everything from improvements in the care and delivery around PrEP, but also improvements in the care, the importance of it continuing to improve the delivery of care through the care continuum. There's a result out of the CDC that'll be very anticipated this week that really gets to, if we can just improve the care continuum, continue to make improvements in this area, we can deal with up to 90% of the HIV infections that are occurring in the United States. In the area of hepatitis C, we have seen game-changing results in hepatitis C. We expect to be some fairly significant presentations this week in terms of how the drugs are working in both HIV positive and HIV negative people. This is all going to be incredibly exciting. And in addition, we'll see work on cure and on the non-infectious comorbidities associated with residual HIV disease in well-treated individuals. So tonight at the plenaries, we're going to hear two really important presentations, one from David Cooper on the past, the present, and the future of HIV therapy. As we think about where we are today compared to when we were in Vancouver in 1996 with the first results on heart, we have many drug combinations, one pill once a day, that are very safe and very well tolerated. As we look to the future, we're looking to improve therapy through the discovery and development of long-acting therapy, as well as then other therapies that could modulate the minimum residual disease in terms of improving the health of the individual, not just through suppression of the virus, but also suppressing the inflammation that we see in HIV-positive people. The other presentation tonight is by Charles Rice, or Charlie as he is known in the field, and he's going to really delineate the progress that we've made in hepatitis C over the past several years, where we do have this revolution. But I think the really interesting thing about hepatitis C, as we look at it in the dually infected people, hepatitis C, HIV co-infection, defines a group of very difficult to reach individuals. As we think about improving the care continuum, being able to draw people in through the fact that they are dually infected, that if they adhere to therapy, even as little as 10 or 12 weeks of therapy, we can cure and eliminate one of their major health events in their lives, and then use that as a stepping stone to improve their access to care, getting them to the HIV care continuum. This is really a benefit and a bonus to us who are primarily HIV providers, but ultimately it does improve the health of the individual and improves the health of the nation by eliminating, really getting to where we can eliminate hepatitis C. That is the long-term vision that we have that'll come out of the plenaries tonight. Very early in the conference, we're going to see some very important breaking news from the NIH. One is from the PROMISE study, which will talk about the impact of the antiretroviral treatment on the earliest events in transmission from mother to baby. Some very significant results will be presented there. We're going to hear from the HBTN-065 study about the impact of financial incentives on uptake into care and also into viral suppression. Those will be two of the major highlights tomorrow. In a non-NIH supported trial, we'll hear the results of the FACS study, FACS-001, which is the follow-up to CAPRISA-004. We expect all of those to be available very early on Tuesday.
For more information about the conference, visit www.croy2015.org. And for more information on federal HIV programs, visit aids.gov.